Hey guys, Mark Boswell here again with another video short. This video is a discussion on the recent practice question number 754. Practice question 754. I don't have the notes in front of me, so I'm going to do it basically off the top of my head from memory. But the question was, your patient presents with a blood pressure, and I believe it was like 70 systolic over 50 something diastolic, and a heart rate of 58. Which of the following answer choices would be the appropriate intervention for this patient? Your choices were, and I don't remember the exact order, so forgive me, but your choices were, one, norepinephrine, which is levofed. Another one was epinephrine, IV. Another one was crystalloid fluid bolus. And another one was colloid fluid bolus, okay? The correct answer was the norepinephrine, the levofed IV, and we'll discuss that for a minute because it will give you a few learning points about shock and some of the teaching learning points with CEN about that. I wanted to do this video, and I pretty much knew I was going to do a video discussion about this as soon as the answers started rolling in on Facebook, because I saw a lot of people were getting it wrong. I think I only counted, last count, three people got the right answer, which was the norepinephrine. So let's talk about why that's the right answer, because I want you guys to learn from that. I think a lot of people that picked the crystalloid solution, i.e. normal saline or LR, we're kind of going with the old standard trauma, hypotension, volume replacement paradigm, which is fine. I mean, I'm glad that you think of that, but this question was specifically questioning about neurogenic shock and the interventions for that. I'm sorry if the camera's a little bouncy. I guess the pavement here on the interstate isn't too great over this spot. But the purpose of this was to test about neurogenic shock and intervention for that, which is the norepinephrine or the levofed. So looking back at the question, all I gave you was a patient with two pieces of vital signs. I gave you a blood pressure and a heart rate, and that's all you needed to know. So obviously the blood pressure, the patient's hypotensive at 70 systolic. You can calculate the MAP for that if you want. You don't need to, but I think that's a no-brainer. They're hypotensive. So that meets the criteria for shock. But how about that heart rate? Heart rate less than 60, okay? And a lot of people that picked the crystalloid solution, I want you to rethink that. If you're given a fluid bolus, look at the heart rate, okay? Heart rate and blood pressure, all right? But in this case, the heart rate makes it not your normal hypovolemic shock. So let's quickly review. We've got four types of shock according to the ENA and TNCC. And of course, we know the CEN mirrors those two bodies. So our four types of shock are hypovolemic, distributive, cardiogenic, and obstructive. Okay, and every other shock type, the heart rate is going to go up. Okay, so what I'm looking for here was that, could you pick out that this was neurogenic shock, which does have a different intervention than the other types do? Okay, so neurogenic shock is a subtype of distributive shock. There are three types of distributive shock traditionally. There is neurogenic, there is anaphylactic, and there is septic shock. Your distributive shock types, and I'll talk more about this in another lecture or video at some point, but your distributive shocks, those three, they are a problem with the pipes of the system, the blood vessels, okay? Generally, you hear some authors and presenters talk about your blood pressure, your perfusion, as having a pump, a tank, and then the pipes that carry the fluid, okay? Neurogenic shock is a problem with the pipes. The pipes have gotten large or dilated for whatever reason, and when those pipes get big, there's less pressure exerted against the walls. That translates to a lower blood pressure. And in neurogenic shock, the offensive or the offending insult or the agent of injury, if you will, is a spinal cord injury. A spinal cord injury at a certain level, and it breaks the communication between the spinal cord, which is the CNS, and the blood vessels. So basically, the CNS is still sending out the signals to tell the blood vessels to tighten up and stay constricted and maintain their tone for a good perfusion pressure, but they're not getting the message. There's something between the spinal cord and the blood vessels that communication has been cut, okay? So blood vessels are just left wandering around doing their own thing, and when they don't have control from the sympathetic system, those blood vessels dilate and get big, and the blood pressure goes down. Okay. The unique thing about neurogenic shock is that the heart rate is going to be low or bradycardic. And this is because the sympathetic transmitters, although they can't find their way to the blood vessels, they find their way to the vagus nerve, and they cause an overstimulation of the vagus nerve. So what you see basically is a vagal response dropping that blood pressure. So neurogenic shock is the only shock type that has a low blood pressure and a low heart rate. All right. So that being said, we identify this as neurogenic shock. What's an appropriate intervention? Okay. You could try fluids, but remember on this test, whenever it says what's the best, the priority, the most important, you're always looking for the definitive treatment to what the problem is. You're not just putting a Band-Aid on something. You want to answer and pick the most specific intervention that fixes the problem. In neurogenic shock, we need to increase that vascular tone. Okay? We need to increase that vascular tone. Now, there's nothing we can do at the bedside to suddenly reestablish that communication between the sympathetic system, i.e. the spinal cord, and the blood vessels. We can't fix that at the bedside. So we need to artificially increase the vascular tone. This is where your norepinephrine, your levofed, comes in. Norepi is a strong alpha agonist, and your alpha cells are on your peripheral vasculature, your arterioles. Okay, so when you stimulate these alpha cells, the vessels are going to tighten back up, the blood pressure is going to go up, and because of that, your perfusion pressure increases across that vessel wall. Giving a fluid bolus won't necessarily do this. It may help in the short interim, and by all means, there's nothing wrong with trying it, but because you know it's neurogenic shock, as evidenced by the bradycardia, you need to pick the best answer for neurogenic, which is norepi or levofed. So why is epi not the right answer? Epi would increase your blood pressure. Epi, we don't need the epi because epi is going to cause some problems or some changes with the heart rate and the increase in cardiac demand. And epi is our specific answer for anaphylactic shock, where we need both the peripheral vascular tone to increase as well as the bronchodilation, because an anaphylactic shock is both a vascular as well as a pulmonary response causing the bronchoconstriction. So epi would be the answer for anaphylactic shock. Your standard crystalloids, they would be for your fluid loss shock. So typically we think about trauma blood loss. Remember, it could also be hypotensive if they're hypovolemic from third spacing, from burns, from GI losses, etc., or excessive diuresis, things like that. So crystalloids would be the preferred when you know it's a fluid volume problem, not a problem with the pipes, okay? Colloids, usually not a first line treatment within most US hospital settings. We tend to see colloids used first line more in austere environments, tactical environments where resources are limited, and let's say, for example, a combat medic can't carry 6 liters of normal saline, but he can carry 250 bags of HEDA starch. Okay, so colloids would help to expand that vascular volume, but again, colloids would be for a fluid loss problem, so you're looking at some type of hypovolemic shock as far as being the requisite condition for that. So back in summary, patient with that low blood pressure and that low heart rate was supposed to trigger you to think neurogenic shock. Neurogenic shock needs a vasopressor, norepi or levofed is the preferred go-to one for this, which increases the vascular tone, brings the blood pressure up, but yet does not cause as much cardiac overstimulation or pulmonary response as epinephrine does. Epi would be the answer for anaphylactic, and then crystalloids for your hypovolemic patient, followed maybe possibly by colloids once you determine more what the problem is. So I hope this helped answer the question. I hope it was a good review for neurogenic shock and the four types of shock in general. I'll be putting another question up not too soon after this. Feel free to comment, like, and share down below. Appreciate when you can share these with your some of your other emergency nurses or ER or even paramedics. Get some paramedic students too. They don't know about this page, and so if you'll share it with them, I think they'll find it useful as well too. Y'all be safe. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.